So how does Rainbow fit into your Max for Life workflow? In most cases, when you're making a custom Max for Life audio device, MIDI device, or instrument that doesn't need to utilize the Max for Live API or the Live Object model, you might consider taking the entire process over to Rainbow. There are several advantages to using Rainbow in Max for Live. Rainbow has what we call simple polyphony. Turning a monophonic patcher into a polyphonic patcher is fast and simple with Rainbow using simple polyphony. You can make a rainbow patcher polyphonic with the @polyphony attribute. Let Rainbow handle the voice allocation for incoming MIDI data from Live and simply set the number of voices you'd like to use. It's that easy. Another advantage to using Rainbow is DSP performance. By exporting your Rainbow Patcher to a Max External, you gain all of the performance advantages you would expect of a native Max object. If your Max for Live devices are becoming heavy on the CPU when using many voices of polyphony, try porting this over to Rainbow and exporting it as a Max External and compare the performance. Exporting your Rainbow Patch to a Max External also results in a performance boost to load times in Ableton Live sets and device initialization, especially with complex polyphonic Max for Live devices. Converting to Rainbow's Max External target can provide significant improvement in project and device load time. Developing a Max for Live device using Rainbow has another payoff in addition to faster loading. Anything that you've built inside of Rainbow now has the possibility of easily working across many platforms, regardless of what operating system you are using. The nature of Rainbow's target export means you can now cross-compile into a plugin for other platforms and operating systems. Use it as an engine for hardware devices, or host it in a website and other groovy targets. Syncing your Rainbow Patcher to Live's transport will be familiar to Max for Live developers as it works in a similar way, with only a few differences when exporting to a Max External. Let's take a look at how we achieve this. Drag in a new Max for Live audio device, MIDI effect, or instrument. Open the Max for Live device by hitting the Edit button. This will launch Max and put you straight into Max's editing mode. Make a new object, Rainbow Tilde. This will open up the Rainbow Patching environment. Let's make a new object and type phaser tilde space 1n space @lock space 1. Underneath it, make another new object and type out tilde space 1. This will allow us to send out our phaser tilde signal back into the top level Max for Live device from Rainbow. To the right of this, make another new object and type transport. Above this, make another object, metro space 4n space @active 1, and connect its output to the left input of transport. This will bang transport and ensure that it reports its current value when Live's transport is running. Underneath the transport, make an out space 2 object. Connect the first outlet from transport, which is a bar count, to the inlet of the out 2. This will allow us to have the position in bars in the top level Max for Live device. If we go back to the top level Max for Live editing window, we can connect a live.scope tilde to the first outlet of Rainbow to see the phaser that is locked to Live's transport. We can also attach a number to the second outlet of Rainbow Tilde to see the bar count. If you stop and start live transport, you'll see that the phaser signal and bar count runs, stops, and resets perfectly in sync with live. The signal and the bar count allows for a great starting point for building sequences, modulation, sync, or anything else where timing and synchronicity with live is important. Now that we've made our rainbow patch and it's synced to Live's transport, let's turn this rainbow patch into a native Max external. To export your Max external from Rainbow, hit the Show Export Sidebar button in the right toolbar when you're inside of a Rainbow patcher. Let's export our Rainbow Sync patcher as a dedicated external. Select Max External Export in the sidebar. We can choose a custom export path. The default works best as it means your newly exported external will be immediately available in Max. We can also select the export platform. Yes, we can build Windows externals from a Mac, give our external a custom name, set an author, description, and search tags. There are also several toggle options. For further details on these, check out the target export videos and articles. The toggle we're interested in here is the include transport attribute. This allows our newly exported synced Rainbow patcher to be in sync with a named transport inside of Max and Max for Live using the attribute @transport. Okay, let's hit the export button in the bottom right corner. Once this is completed, we can type the name of our external in the patcher of your Max for Live device and you'll see it instantiate. If you attach a scope and a number to your new Max object and turn on Live's transport, you will see that it is perfectly in sync with Live. There's a couple of extra steps we need to make if we intend to share this device. We need to ensure that this new external is bundled with the device when we save it. Click the Space Invader looking icon in the bottom toolbar when in the editing mode of your Max for Live device. A second window pane will pop up and show all of the dependencies of your device. This is the Project window pane. Anything added in here is included and copied when you freeze and save your device, regardless of where it originated from on your hard drive. Let's include in project our newly made external. Freeze the device and save. Now we can share this device with anyone else we like and be sure that the external is included. Happy patching!